Welcome to Bytes and Bolts, a podcast where we seek to improve ourselves, our work, and the web industry as a whole. I'm your host, Jon Daiello, and today we're going to be continuing our discussion about humility and how humility itself can't stand alone. In the last podcast, we talked about the necessity of humility in the web industry, and specifically in relation to education. And I highly recommend that you go back and listen to that podcast, or go back and read my article, and then continue on here. But if you decide not to, the basic premise was that you can't learn if you aren't humble. You can't be teachable if you aren't willing to put away your pride. One of my favorite quotes from that whole segment was, "If you open up your mind for a few minutes and close your mouth, you might learn something." And I believe this to be 100% true. However, it doesn't fully encompass the breadth of the conversation. If someone is standing on humility alone, that won't be enough. And that's why I decided to write this follow-up article and have this follow-up discussion, because it is an extremely important conversation that we need to continue. So, what is confidence? And before we get too far, let's set some parameters for our discussion. When I refer to confidence, I'm not talking about pride. Don't confuse the two. Pride and confidence are different. They are distinctly different and separate things. Confidence is the idea that you believe you can succeed. Now, pride, on the other hand, is taking it too far. It's considering yourself better than others or feeling that you deserve some certain amount of respect. All right, now with our variables defined, let's continue on. So humility really needs a partner. It's only going to get you so far. You can't stand on humility alone. You need to couple humility with confidence. Because four things we need to remember. First, you can learn. Second, you can experiment. Third, you can be great. Don't put yourself down. This is the fourth and final one. Don't put yourself down and expect to fail. You need to have a healthy dose of confidence in this industry. It's a tricky balancing act for sure. However, it's one that must be practiced for you to get it right. So if you haven't already started thinking about it, fire up that gray matter processor and get on it. Make sure that you are pursuing confidence and going after it. I encourage you to have confidence and to work and succeed at your craft, to continue to bolster your confidence. It's a necessity. On the other hand, if we guard against pride, it's really the antithesis to a cohesive web community. It's the opposite mentality that we need to have for a mind that is ready to learn. So how do we get confidence? How do we go about gaining it? Well, I put together some practical ways of building humility's lifelong companion, of building confidence. Five main things that I have found that have been extremely helpful in my journey toward confidence. So, number one, don't put yourself down. If you're in the habit of putting yourself and your work down, stop it and stop it now. Instead, find ways to interact with others and your work that will help you to highlight the aspects of your work that really do shine. Number two, focus on your successes. It's easy to get down when we fail. Trust me, I fail all the time. Try stuff, doesn't work out. We all do. It's part of the process. So keep your failures in perspective and balance them with your other successes that you have had. Number three, break it down. Now, everybody knows that a giant project is often overwhelming, and it's hard and overwhelming and often distracting to think about designing and building an entire project scope. So instead, focus on the small, incremental pieces and accomplish those bits and bytes with greatness. Number four, get some perspective. Now, if you're having trouble with something, find some eyes or some ears to borrow. They can be anyone. They don't even have to be in the industry. Sometimes just the act of explaining something can help you find a new solution or perspective for the task at hand. All right, so the last one and the fifth one, keep at it. Hard work is crucial to learning new things. as you consistently work at it, you'll have more and more successes that you can stockpile away in your confidence cabinet. If you encounter frustration or feel like giving up, go back to number one and repeat. So in conclusion, just remember that humility is only going to get you halfway. Humility needs to be coupled with confidence for you and for your work to succeed. So as your confident quotient increases, you'll find that new challenges start to appear more like exciting opportunities. And that seemingly impossible issue will turn into another great learning experience. And confidence will help you get there. You are capable. Don't forget that we all have to start somewhere. And even the greatest minds in the industry have had to build up their confidence quotient just like you. So keep your focus on where you want to go. Remember to stay positive and keep your state of mind in a mind that is ready to learn. Formula is humility plus confidence, and we all win. Thanks again for listening to the show. These thoughts that I've been kind of mulling over the past few weeks, I've been dealing with them my entire career, and I just thought that it'd be really helpful for especially people who are coming into the industry, who are newer, just to remember that you got to have confidence. You can't just be humble, but most importantly, to focus on learning, focus on doing a greater job. It's going to benefit you. It's going to benefit the community, and everyone is going to be better for it. You, the web, and the users. So thanks a lot. If you have questions, comments, start a discussion, feel free to reach out to me on Twitter. You can find me at Jon Daiello. Thanks a lot.